G'day guys, and welcome back to Thornton Farm. So here we are on field number 11, continuing with the harvest. I'm just going to go and unload the combine. Of course, we better let the handbrake off first, so we won't go anywhere. So he's getting, he's at 81%. So we'll unload him on the way down here. And, there's a post. Shit. I'll just finish letting him unload. I'll just stop him. So this is the problem with the posts we have on this field. So I'll just reverse him up. Just move this other tractor out of the way. Okay, so we'll just leave the John Deere there. Let's put the handbrake on so it doesn't roll off. So what I'll do is just get it around the game to continue, and of course we may have to do the same when he comes back up, so we'll just ride along with him for a second. For a few seconds, and we'll see. So yeah, we've done about, I guess, what, half the field, I guess we'd say. So I'm just, yeah, it's just got to work. Now we're in amongst all these power poles, I just got to work it. So as he gets to it, I'll just have to stop him and go around. Yeah, because I'm pretty sure that he'll hit that. Yep, almost 100% positive he'll hit that. So what I'll do is I will stop him there. So I'll just get him. And I hit the post myself. Nice one. Like that, and then I'll just hit drive again. There we go. So now he should be good until we get to the next post further down the field there. Okay, we're slowly getting this harvest done. As you can see, I've done so much of the field. Probably, like I said, I might be about half, maybe just a tad over half of the field done. So yeah, this is the biggest field. I think this is the biggest field on the map, actually. Yeah, this is the biggest field. So the big fields that we have, well, that are on the map, is 13, which will be our next field that will harvest. 38 looks like it's, no, it's not that big. 27 looks like a decent size. 22 down the bottom there, and 26 over that, right over the other side, and maybe field 30. All the rest don't look too bad, but then again, looking at the minimap, that can be deceiving. Okay, so we'll get this harvested, try and get it finished in this episode. We'll see how we go. Obviously, I'm just using Courseplay to do this. I haven't worried about doing this one myself. On field 13, I'll probably do a couple of headlands myself, and then probably use auto combine on that one. So with this field, as far as with the straw goes, I'm not going to bale this field. I'm actually going to hire a forage harvester. I'm going to pick the straw up that way, turn it to chaff and take it to the silage pit at the farm, and finish filling that silage pit up that we started the other day with the grass. I don't know if it will fill it up, but we'll put all this into it if we can, if it will fit. I think it will. But field 13, I'm going to bale, probably won't bale all of it, because I don't think I need to. I think I just need to bale enough to get me going to start with, plus there's plenty of other fields on the map that we still have to buy and harvest. So I think I did say in, was it the last episode or in the first episode, that I was going to harvest all the fields regardless of whether I owned them or not. I've since changed my mind on that. I've decided I'm not going to harvest them. If I don't own them, I won't be harvesting them. So the goal will be to buy the fields and then harvest the field. So he's getting up to, what's he at, 65%? So I think we'll see what he's at when he comes back up again. Actually, he'll be getting close to that pole too. No, actually, we'll jump to the tractor and we'll see if we can unload him now. Should put four-wheel drive on, actually, while working on the field, just to make it a little easier. So you may have noticed that this John Deere is a different one from the one I was using previously. I actually changed it out. I'd had some concerns with the other one. It felt like it was too light in the front, even with no trailer or implement or anything on. It just felt a little too light. So what I'll do is I'll go back up and I'll meet this guy back up at the top here, if I can get back up before him. And this is a different mod. It's done by, if I think about it, what was it, FBM modding? I'll have to recheck that, but the link for this one will be in my description. So this is a nice version of the model as well. I think this one has bigger tires, different sound, and all that. I think all the IC was pretty much the same. So we'll just unload again when we're going down, just see if we can get this trailer full, since it's just about full. We're at 89%, and then we can take that back to the farm and unload. But I'll probably have to sort him out for the next power pole first before we go. So is he going to make it past that power pole this time? I think he will. Just keep your pipe out. Tractor is full, so we'll just take it. I'll be on the way back up, I think. So what we'll do, we'll just put this tractor up here, and we'll just jump back to the combine, and we'll just have to sort him out. Brake on. Yes, we will have to sort him out. He's going to be, I'll have to go around the power pole, I think. So I'll just wait and see whereabouts. is going to be. Try to do it without lifting the header up so I can just keep it. Nope. Not enough. So I think it's going to be when he comes back down as well. So it makes a little bit of a mess of the straw near the power poles, but that's all right. We can work around that. So yeah, well, the field's just about, we're actually doing pretty well, to be honest. I might actually get this done in this episode. It's probably all I'll breathe. It's probably all we're going to be doing, guys, but unfortunately, it's a job that has to be done. I haven't filmed all of the harvest. I started it off in the last episode, and I've done some off screen, and I'll finish the rest in this episode. So let's sort him out on this pole, and then I'll go and dump that load of grain. Hopefully, and he's getting a bit full too. He might actually miss that, I don't know. It looked like he could. Nah. We'll have to wait and see. I'll just hang around here before I go taking off to the farm with the trailer of grain, just in case he needs to be sorted out. I'm hoping he does miss it. I'm not worried about the little bit that might be missed that doesn't get harvested. Actually, I think he will miss that. Yep. Oh, that's alright. Missed a few little bits there, but that's okay. Okay, so we'll just take this grain to the farm and try and get back before he's full, which I don't know if we will. Oh, he's at 58%. So I hope everyone's doing well. Hope life is treating you well. Hope you're enjoying my videos. As I said, I'm only a new YouTube channel. I'm trying the best I can with my videos. Oh, this tractor seems a bit light too. Maybe I need a front weight. I'll put the front weight on while I'm here, I think. Just try that. Never had that before, just with the trailer on the back. If I'm feeling so light in the front, like just getting all weight, like all, you just don't feel like you've got much grip on the front. Turn yet. Should really move that Marshall trailer too. So just unload that there. I'll just move this sprayer so I can get this weight. I think it's in here. Yep. That is hooked on, isn't it? Yeah. So I'll just park this here for now. Okay, he should be finished unloading. I'm going to go forward, and what I'll do is I'll just disconnect the trailer, because I think I need to put the front hooks down. go. Rehook the trailer. Okay. No, don't shut the door. Yeah, it's all good. Probably should have had a front light weight even on the other one as well, but I like the sound of this one. It sounds a bit more, what do you say, beefier. Yeah, we'll say it sounds a little bit more beefier. Obviously, when I do my editing, I'm probably going to have to adjust the game sound anyway to my voice. So let's get this combine unloaded. Whereabouts? Where is he? Must be down. He's down the bottom. Looks like he's low. He's 100%. Okay, so I do have the drive control fitted, but I do have fruit destruction turned off, and the same with the terrain and dirt mod. I've actually removed the. I think it had a fruit destruction in it as well. Basically, when you drive over your crop, it just turns it to straw. That part, like, I could have left it on in drive control, that would be fine. It would just kill the crop off a bit and leave a trail there. Oops, okay, closer here. But the one from the terrain and dirt mod, I didn't really think that was realistic, as if you drive over a crop, it's not going to automatically turn to straw. I don't really like destroying the crop anyway. I don't think it looks very good, and my thing is, it is only a game, so I'm not concerned about destroying the crop. So let him go. I mean, I'm not really, don't really want to destroy the crop. This is just how I play the game. Other people play it differently, so I know it won't suit some people, they won't like that, but that's just my play style, so please don't hate because of that. Everybody, I've watched plenty of other YouTubers, everyone, I've noticed everyone plays the game differently. So how are we going to go for that pole down there? So we might just jump in with the combine and ride along with him for a few minutes. Oh, he's working with the door open. Does this have IC? Or is there a function to open the door? Open closed door 5. Oh, that's gonna suck, isn't it? So that's the same function for auto combine. I can still turn that off though. Yeah, we'll leave the door open. You could probably harvest with the door open anyway. No, we'll shut it. That okay. So next pass down, we're gonna have to deal with this power pole. That'll be the last one on the field. So I might run this episode till we finish this field. We're at 20 minutes. So I'm pretty sure this won't take. Actually, using this with course plates, it's been really quick to do it. even what I've done off camera, I didn't spend that much time doing it off camera, just let course play go and do it really quick. That's good. And the header I'm using is a 7.6 meter header. I think this is a good size header for the map at the moment. And the reason why I bought this CR890 New Holland was that I can, I think it also takes, let's have a quick look in the shop here, or in the garage, it also can take the 9.7 meter header. So when it comes to it later on, when we can afford it, we could actually just upgrade the header on this combine instead of the whole combine. Which I don't know whether I will do, or I might just keep this combine and maybe buy a second combine and have two of them, because I do like these CR, these ones from the CR pack. They're pretty well done, and they work. They don't seem to have any problems. Obviously, it would be good if they could have a bit of a build-up of straw or something at the front, at just where the pickup hooks onto there, or where the header hooks onto, I mean. But other than that, it gets dirty. So I'd say the pipe is only designed just for those two headers. Obviously, you can't go up with the 12-meter header on that you get. Oop, better pay attention here too. Coming up to this last power pole. So I think we're going to have to go around it. Just stop him there. Okay, so I'll just reverse him up a bit. Let's see what he does if I hit drive course now. It's going to make a mess of it. Stop, driver. Stop. You fool. You've made a mess. Let's have a look. So which way is he going to go? No. Where is he going? Where does he think he's going? I better bring up the course here. See where to put him. Oh, he's all the way over there. Really? Okay. There we go. Just get rid of that. Let's have a look. So he should be all good now. He's got one, two, he's got this one, and he's got one, two, three, and a little bit left to go. Passes to go. So if you're wondering, just for with the icon here that comes up, this is actually the developer version of Courseplay. It's usually it's pretty much available to download with your normal Courseplay, where if you can download the normal Courseplay version, I think it is anyway. I'm pretty sure that's how I downloaded my one. So we'll just get this guy unloaded. Seems he's ready to get unloaded again. Of course, we'll just wait for him to turn around. So I should really get a John Deere weight, also a rack of weights to go on the front of this. I don't know if I've got any or not. Just fill up a bit in the front of the trailer, So yeah, looks like if I drive straight down the net, the swath that he's just done, that's pretty much accurate for unloading. If I can keep it straight. So I'll move forward a little bit more. So I do like the drive control function, that when you change it down the bottom there, you'll see two little arrows. And that just allows you, when you hit your cruise control, it'll just match the same speed as your combine. I really do like that feature. Makes doing this a lot easier than trying to do it manually. Okay, so we will... Now I'm just wondering if I'm going to fit in what's left on this field. So he's only got a couple of passes. No, I'll go and empty it out while he's doing that. We'll go empty it out. Of course, the only downside is when you want to use your cruise control, you have to turn that back off again. And so we'll just head back to the farm. I know the trailer's not full, but it's 76% full. So it looks like this episode will be just on 30 minutes, or around the 30 minute mark. Hope that's not... Well, I think some of the earlier ones were a bit longer, so... Okay, so I also want to do some wood chipping. And I think I might do that in the next episode. I'll hire some of the machines to do that. Some different machinery for that. But the way I do it is the lazy way. It's basically just with a Brooks chipper on the front. The model, the mod that I, the one that I do have, actually will, it actually pretty much does everything. We'll cut the tree, chip it, and also grind the stump out. All in one thing. You don't even have to get out of the tractor to do anything. And that's how I like to do my wood chipping. Now that one is only, I've only just recently found that one. And it makes wood chipping very easy. So I will put a... I wasn't going to originally record it. I thought, no, I won't do it because not everybody likes that style of doing it. Like, it's nothing really involved, except drive up to a tree, you know, open out, put the pipe out on the Brooks chipper, open it up, turn it on, drive up to the tree, and just, it does everything. But I thought I'd do it anyway. And I will put a link for, if I can remember where I downloaded it from, I will put a link for that chipper. I will find the link for that chipper when I do it. Just if anyone out there that doesn't like wood chipping like I, or doesn't really like doing much forestry work but still want to make some wood chips, but just do it quick and easy to get it done. So, oh, it looks like he's finished. Okay. No, he's just finishing now. He's just finished the last little bit. So this is field number 11. Okay guys, this is field number 11, completely harvested. And we'll just get this guy unloaded. So I probably could have got it all into the... actually, we'll stop course play first. And we'll get rid of that. We'll just put the pipe out. Okay, so we'll just get this guy unloaded, and then I'll end the episode, and I'll clean up and take the trailer back, and I'll take the trailer back and empty it out. So he's only going to have, not much, only what is it, 9%. Yeah, I should have waited. I thought there might have been a little bit more than that. So, actually, I'll leave him there because I can do a screenshot. put him back under the pipe. Okay, so I'll make this a screenshot, I think. Okay, okay guys, I'm going to end the episode here. Thank you for watching. If you like the episode, please comment, rate and subscribe. Or hit that likes up button. Lets me know that you're liking my episodes on Thornton Farm, and helps me, encourages me to keep doing it. And I will see you in tomorrow's episode, which will be back here on Thornton Farm. bit tongue twister then. So I'll do that, as I was just talking about, I'll do some of that forestry. I'll have to hire the equipment. I think I'm going to sort of fast forward time a little bit too. I'll just sort of pass a bit of time. So, you know, I don't want to go, like, it's in game time now, it's 20 to 12. I'm not going to go and say do some wood chipping. It's only like might be 12:30 by the time we're finished with that. And then go start harvesting field 13 or something like that. And it's only like 1 in the afternoon now. I'm pretty sure that you wouldn't do that in real life that quickly. So I might just pass a couple of hours and we'll do that. So I'm not going to move straight on to field 13. I'm not sure with this field whether to get the forage forage harvester and pick this straw up, or whether to I'll do the forestry in the I'll do some chipping in the next episode. We'll do a bit of wood chipping. So I'll make some wood chips and put them in the storage, so when we get a great demand, we've got wood chips. Okay guys, thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.